We are going to be harnessed and tethered, but for the demonstration, we really don't need a purpose of that right now. So the first thing that we want to do is, it's not just a rescue, as I said before, it's patient care. So we want to make sure that the person is going to be a little bit more comfortable, because they may not be in medical peril at this point, but there's still going to be panic, and panic leads to shock. And of course, shock does not lead to very good things. So simplest things can really, really help us when we do medical type of responses. So we're going to make the patient feel comfortable. So the first thing we're going to do is that we're going to secure them. So we're going to wrap them and tie them off and let them feel that he's not going to go anywhere anywhere further. At least that's what we're going to set them up with. And then we're also going to provide them with some oxygen just to make them feel comfortable. And it starts to lower blood pressure and pulse all the time, just a little bit of oxygen and making the person comfortable. And then when we start our rescue. The rescue, all of the work has to be done from behind the victim as much as possible. So we don't want to be pushing any product towards vital organs. We've got to stay away from that. If there's an awful lot of product up around his chest and it's being pushed in still with every breath, it's just going to get tighter and tighter for him to breathe because he's not going to be able to expand his chest. So they're making Stevie feel comfortable that way. We run a lot of medical calls. We really do out of the 45, 50 calls that we've ran so far this year, or the 90-some-odd calls last year. We run about anywhere from 45, 55, 60% are medical calls. We get there before EMS. We also just don't do a St. John's first aid. We have a higher level of training called a first responder training. And we're getting pretty skilled at medical calls. And we get in there pretty quick and make people feel comfortable. And we have all kinds of other tools on our rig to help with medical situations as well. So, but that's one of our primary goals in this situation as well. Not just getting them out, but it is all a medical situation. So the GET tool is four sleeves that slide together. After the demonstration, I'll bring the GET tool out front here and you guys can have a closer look at it if you'd like. So one of the questions I'll try to answer before, well, what if we can't get the tools? What if we can't get the tools inside the bin? Well, we have saws on our trucks. We'll get through that metal, we'll make a little bigger door, and we'll get the tool in. And now, the other way that we can sort of help that person who's trapped feel a little bit better is get them to help in their own rescue. So we're going to just provide some pails once he gets his hands free. We're going to slide the panel down this way. Some fire departments like to use a shop vac if it's if they're able to do it, be able to get electrical supply up there, and use the vac that way as well. But any means at all is going to help that person when they start helping themselves. I asked the question before at the other demonstration if anybody had ever found themselves sort of trapped or in a bit of a tight spot with this stuff before, and no one put their hand up. Maybe they're just shy. They don't want to admit that their neighbors around here. I understand that. I was intentionally put in there, and it's surprisingly how much product has to be moved before you can move your thighs to start to walk yourself out and tramp the stuff down to get it to keep moving. You have to get an awful lot of product out of your way. It's not just like get to here and you're free and clear. You got to get darn stuff below your knees, really, before you can start to move it. It is really, really tough to move in there. So I asked a couple gentlemen before, in between demonstrations, what would be the real need for anybody to go in there, being a non-agricultural guy? I didn't understand that. I don't get that. So, you know, maybe that message is getting through, because we've never had to run a rescue like that, and they do occur, but they're somewhat rare, thank God, because they're not all rescues. You know, all you have to do is listen to the radio every year, and you'll hear about ones that don't go very well. And it's that quick for Stevie to get out. It's really that quick. And this is a perfect demonstration. But if he's buried inside a bin with a lot of product, it's going to take a long time. As I said before, that one fire department outside of Ottawa took 8 hours. They didn't have a tool, and they had to improvise when they got there. And they're using sheets of plywood, and it didn't go so well. But it was a rescue. It wasn't a recovery.